CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 2.
Hello students, how are you? Today we are going to do chapter 2 of our class 2, that is counting in groups.
And for this we are Kulvinder and Neeraj here for you.
Hi from Kulvinder.
Hello from Neeraj.
So Neeraj, for this chapter we need to do some counting.
Counting? I love counting.
So I thought you had some song for our children.
Yes, actually this is a song which we do with our class 2 students. I am a teacher and I do this song with my class 2 students. So let's do it here too.
Yes, we'll enjoy that and our kids will also learn that and enjoy that.
Yes, for this song you have to repeat. Whatever I say, however I say, you have to just copy it.
Yes kids, we'll repeat. After Neeraj will sing the song, she'll speak a line and we'll repeat after her.
So the song goes like this. Rabbits, rabbits, 1, 2, 3.
Rabbits, rabbits, 1, 2, 3.
Will you come and play with me?
Will you come and play with me?
Camels, camels, 4, 5, 6.
Camels, camels, 4, 5, 6.
Why do you have a hump like this?
Why do you have a hump like this?
Monkeys, monkeys, 7, 8, 9.
Monkeys, monkeys, 7, 8, 9.
Will you teach us how to climb?
Will you teach us how to climb?
When we have counted up to 10.
When we have counted up to 10.
The elephant says, start again.
The elephant says, start again.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, the kids, now I think you have got an idea about the rhyme. So now, whenever we say a number in this rhyme, you have to show that number with your fingers. Right? Like if I say 1, 2, 3, then on 1, we would show our 1 finger. On 2, we would show our 2 fingers. And on 3, we'll show our 3 fingers. Right?
Yes.
So we will repeat the song, but a little faster. Right?
Yes.
So are you ready?
We all are ready.
Rabbits, rabbits, 1, 2, 3. Rabbits, rabbits, 1, 2, 3. Will you come and play with me?
Rabbits, rabbits, 1, 2, 3. Rabbits, rabbits, 1, 2, 3. Will you come and play with me?
Camels, camels, 4, 5, 6. Why do you have a hump like this?
Camels, camels, 4, 5, 6. Why do you have a hump like this?
Monkeys, monkeys, 7, 8, 9. Will you teach me how to climb?
Monkeys, monkeys, 7, 8, 9. Will you teach me how to climb?
When we have counted up to 10, the elephant says, start again.
When you have counted up to 10, elephant says, count again.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
But Neeraj, what comes after 10?
After 10 comes 11.
11. So let's count after 10.
Okay. After 10 comes 11, 12, 13, 14, 15,
16,
17,
18,
19,
and
20.
20. So now, when we have counted up to 20, let's do some counting exercises.
This counting up to 20 was so much fun. I'm looking forward to more exercises.
But we'll start with smaller numbers.
Smaller numbers? You mean 1, 2?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay.
Now, here are some glasses in front of me. Let us see how many glasses are here.
There are 3 glasses. 1, 2 and 3. Oh, some balls are kept here. Let us count these balls also.
How many balls are here?
Here are, let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 balls.
Yes, these are 5 balls. Oh, wow. You are doing so well. So let's move forward. Let us see what we have got here.
Oh, wow. Here are some patterns as well. Here I can see a design that you have made.
Yes, I made this design with different bindis.
Oh, wow. It is looking nice.
But can you count how many bindis are here?
For that, I need to count each bindi. What should I do now? What do you say, kids? Should I start counting one by one?
But it will be very tedious. You will get tired. There are so many bindis.
So, what should I do?
So, how much do you estimate that how many bindis are here?
There are so many bindis. How can I estimate about the number? Approximately, I think they are about 100 bindis.
So, what will you do now?
So, I need to count all of them. That would take so much time. What should I do now? Let me think. Okay, I have an idea. I will count them, taking them up in groups. And then we can count the groups.
Yes. So let us talk about counting in groups.
I remember whenever my father counts the notes, the money which is in paper notes, and whenever he counts, and if there are too many notes, what he does, he takes a bunch of 10 notes and keep it aside, then a bunch of another 10 notes and then keep it aside, and then a bunch of another 10 notes and then keep it aside. So, I think he makes groups of 10, 10, 10 so that he do not forget the counting.
Yes, but he is so grown up and he has learnt this with practice. So, we'll start with smaller numbers, that how we can see the things in groups and count them in groups.
Let's see how to count in groups.
Here we have some ice creams.
Ice creams. I love ice creams.
Yes, all the kids do. Even I love the ice creams. Cold and sweet.
Yes, but you know, my mother, she always says, after having ice cream, we must clean our teeth very well and we must not eat too many ice creams.
Yes, to prevent the cavities.
Yes.
So here, these ice creams are in different rows. Here we have 3 rows of ice creams.
I can see row 1, row 2 and here is row number 3.
So again let us count that how many ice creams do we have in first row.
Let me count. 1, 2. There are 2 ice creams in first row.
So let us move to next row, that is row number 2. So how many ice creams are there in row 2?
Let me count. Row 2 has 1, 2, 3. 3 ice creams. There are 3 ice creams in row number 2.
So there were 2 ice creams in row number 1 and there are 3 ice creams in row number 2. Now, what next?
I have to count the ice creams in row number 3.
Yes, let us count the number of ice creams in third row, that is row number 3.
Okay, let me count. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 ice creams in row number 3.
But how many ice creams are there in total?
In total, you mean ice creams in row number 1, ice creams in row number 2 and ice creams in row number 3.
All together.
Okay, so let me count. 2, 3 and 4. So let us add all the ice creams. So the total number of ice creams is 2 plus 3 plus 4. It means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Means 9 ice creams.
Yes. 2 ice creams in row number 1 and 3 ice creams in row number 2. That makes up to the total of 5. 2 and 3, 5. And 4 ice creams in row number 3. 5 plus 4 is 9. So, here we have 9 ice creams. So, let us count them one by one to check it. 1,
2,
3,
4,
5, 6,
7,
8,
9.
9 ice creams. So, let us see what do we have next.
Here are some elephants.
Yes. Now, here we have some elephants.
Do you want me to guess how many elephants are there?
Yes.
Maybe they are more than 5.
Are you sure?
I am just estimating. Let us count to be sure.
Yes. They are in 3 rows. So let us count them.
Row number 1 has 1, 2, 2 elephants. Row number 2, it has 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 elephants. And row number 3, it has 2 elephants.
Yes. So,
in total, there are 2 plus 4 plus 2 elephants. So, 2 and 2 is 4 and 4 plus 4 is 8. So, there are 8 elephants.
Yes. So, I see you can see them in different groups and add them. And that's why you could guess that there are probably more than 5 elephants.
I saw that there are 2 elephants in row number 1 and 2 elephants in row number 3. So, I put them together to make 4. And the middle row, it also had 4 elephants. So in total, 4 plus 4 are 8.
Yeah, you are doing very well. You know, when I went to market along with my cousin, I saw various things kept in different groups, in different racks. I tell you, when I went to the crockery shop, I saw some cups kept in racks in 4 rows.
In first row, there was 1 cup. In the second row, there were 2 cups. And the third row, it had 3 cups. Fourth row, and it was last row, it had 4 cups.
So, you know, my cousin Tina asked me, can you tell me how many cups were there?
So, to tell you how many cups were there, we need to add all the cups in all 4 rows.
Yes, I saw them once again, and you kids can write the same in your notebooks, or you can even draw it. How many cups were there in the crockery shop? There was 1 cup in the first row. There were 2 cups in the second row. There were 3 cups in the third row. How many cups were there in the fourth row?
4.
Yes, you are right. There were 4 cups in the fourth row. So, how many cups were there in total?
So, I have to add 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4.
Were there 10 cups?
Maybe it looked like more than 5. But to be sure, I need to count the cups.
How will you count them? Will you count them one by one?
No, I think I can do it by adding 1 plus 4, it makes 5. And 2 plus 3, it also makes 5. That is an easy number. 5 plus 5 is 10.
Yes, there were 10 cups. We see the cups in the rows. And then it becomes easy to count them.
It is easy when we group the numbers.
You know, after that, we went to the shoe shop. There also, she said, now let us see how many pairs of shoes are there in the rack in the shoe shop. Remember, we have to see the shoe pair as one.
The shoe pair as one, it means one pair has 2 shoes.
So, let us see, how many rows are here?
Here we have 3 rows.
And let us count the number of pairs in each row.
So, there are 3 rows. In the first row, there are 3 pairs. In the second row, it has 3 pairs. And the third row, it also has 3 pairs. So, 3 rows having 3 pairs of shoes, it means there are 9 pairs of shoes.
Yes, you see, with practice, we can easily count how many shoe pairs or how many things are there in total.
I see.
So, how much did you count?
I counted 3 plus 3 plus 3. That means 9 pairs.
So, you know, after this, Tina was also very much excited. My cousin. She said, oh, wow. It is so much fun. And she also wanted to try this. Then, in front of the shoe shop, she saw a vendor selling lemon on the thela.
Oh, lemons! That sari thing!
Yeah, and we drink lime water during the hot summers.
Yes, my mother makes yummy lemonade.
Now, Tina was very excited and she also wanted to try counting the lemons. She said, "I will try with these lemons." And she tried to take a guess.
I can also see there are 5 groups and there are 3 lemons in each group. 5 groups and 3 lemons in each group. So it means 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 and plus 3. 5 times 3. So if I count them, it adds up to 15. So there are 15 lemons.
You did it very well, Neeraj. But Tina was stuck. She asked me to help her out. She saw that there were 5 groups with 3 lemons in each. She could not add them up. She could not see them in the groups. But we together did it as you did it. 3 lemons in group 1, 3 lemons in group 2, 3 lemons in group 3, 3 lemons in group 4, and 3 lemons in group 5. So there were 15 lemons. Now can you count the number of matchboxes kept here?
Yes, there are 4 rows of matchboxes and there we have 3 matchboxes in each row. Now I can count them. I can see groups. So there are 4 rows of 3 matchboxes each. If I add them up, it would be 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. It means 12.
Yes, you are absolutely right.
I'll tell you, Kulvinder. One day when I was there in the market, I saw a person who was selling lemons. And he had put all the lemons in small packets. Each packet had 10 lemons. And he was selling them. And he was also telling the price of that potli. And he was saying like, 10 for 10, 10 for 10, 10 for 10, 10 ke 10. He was saying like that. It means that one group of lemons had 10 lemons. And in one potli was 10 lemons. And the price of one potli was 10 rupees. I can relate this grouping to my real life. Like the lemon seller, he was using this grouping thing. And I also remember when my mother was buying new earrings, the earring was in pair. So I think earrings are also sold in groups, in group of 2. That we know as pair. And where else do we see groups? Kids, can you help me out here? Where do we see grouping of numbers?
I see the grouping in the bindi card.
Oh, yes.
They are also sold in groups of 10 or 5.
I saw a bindi card and on each of its flap there were some bindis on the left hand side and on the right hand side, and it was opening like a book. And I have not counted the bindis, but now if I think, they were equal in number.
Yes, I also had the same card and it had 10 bindis on one side and 10 bindis on the other side. So, how many bindis were there in total? 10 bindis and 10 bindis.
20 bindis.
Yes, 2 groups of 10 bindis.
I remember, I went to a marriage and there my cousin was buying bangles. And you know, the bangles also came in groups. in group of 12 each. Oh, just like bananas. They also come in a bunch. 12 bananas make 1 dozen. I can see grouping is all around us. I will ask you another question. For this, you have to guess the number.
Okay, we can guess only if we see the things in groups.
Yes, and you don't have to count but only guess the number. For example, how many teeth are there in your mouth? Are they more than 40 or less than 40?
I think they are less than 40.
Yes. Okay, now tell me, how many matchsticks would there be in a matchbox? More than 30 or less than 30?
There'll be more than 30.
Yes, there are many matchsticks in a matchbox. Okay, number of spokes in one cycle wheel. More than 20 or less than 20?
In one wheel or both the wheels?
In one wheel.
There must be more than 20.
No, actually they are less than 20.
Are they?
Yes.
I'll see it again.
So kids, like this, you can find this number grouping all around you. Like number of seeds in an orange, or number of trees in a row, or number of flowers in flower bed. So you can keep looking at the numbers in groups. They are all around us. So your fun task is to go and look for numbers in groups.
Counting in groups helps us save the time.
Yes. So keep looking for numbers around you. And here I and Kulvinder are saying you bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Bati Lang Lingdo. Produced by Ajit Horo. This series was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.